In the last video, we solved the Airy's equation, y double prime minus xy equals 0. We did a series solution ansatz, and we obtained two independent series. The first one multiplied by the free constant a0, 1 plus x cubed over 3 times 2, plus x to the 6 over 6 times 5 times 3 times 2, etc. The second series multiplied by the free constant a1, x plus x to the 4th over 4 times 3 plus x to the 7th over 7 times 6 times 4 times 3. We can define these two independent series then as two functions. They're called Airy's functions. The first one we call y0 of x. The second one we call y1 of x. Okay. That's all very nice, but when you want to see a function, what you really want to see is a graph of the function. So what does y naught of x look like when you plot it versus x? What does y1 of x look like when you plot it versus x? You can use the power series to plot, but you need, it's accurate when x is small, but very quickly becomes inaccurate when x is large. You need more and more terms. It's not a very efficient numerical method to plot. Instead, you can use a built-in ODE solver. In MATLAB, you would use something called ODE 45. And it would be a very quick solution to plot y0 and y1. But you need some information to plot these two functions. What you need is two initial conditions. You cannot do the numerical solution of a differential equation, a second order differential equation, unless you have two initial values, y of 0 and y prime of 0. The nice thing about these series solutions is that these have very specific then initial values. So this y naught of x satisfies this differential equation with the following initial values, right? Y naught of 0, if you plug in x equals 0, this is 1, right? And y naught prime of 0, if you take the derivative of this, the leading term will be x squared. So that will be 0. So if you solve this second order differential equation with the initial conditions y of 0 equals 1 and y prime of 0 equals 0, the solution you get is this, the solution of this function y naught of x represented by this power series. For this one, you have y1 of 0. Plugging in x equals 0, all terms have an x in them, so that would be 0. And y1 prime of 0, taking the derivative of x is 1, all the other terms will go to 0, so that will be 1. So if you use the initial conditions y1 of 0 equals 0, and y1 prime of 0 equals 1, and you solve this numerically, this differential equation numerically, you'll get the y1 of x represented by this power series. Let's have a look at the graph then of the solution. The upper graph is y0 of x versus x. If you look at x equals 0, you see that y0 of 0 equals 1. And the derivative of the function at x equals 0 is 0. The bottom graph is y1 of x versus x. If you look at x equals 0, you'll see y1 of 0 equals 0. And the derivative of that function at x equals 0 is 1. The most compelling feature of these graphs is that they're oscillatory for negative x and growing exponentially for positive x. Let's go back and look at the equation and see why that's the case. Okay, so let's have a look at the equation. Y double prime minus xy equals 0. When x is negative, this has a y double prime plus something times y equals 0. We know that y double prime plus y equals 0. That's our sine and cosine function. So this is oscillatory. Okay, which is why for negative x, the Airy's functions are oscillatory because of this plus sign, x is negative. If x is positive, the equation would look something like y double prime minus y equals 0. The coefficient is varying, but the sign is correct. This type of equation has exponentially growing and exponentially decaying solutions. So this is exponential. And what you see in the solution of the numerical solution of the Airy's equation is the exponentially growing solution. Okay, so let me summarize and review. We did solve the Airy's equation, a non-constant coefficient equation, using a series solution method. This was our solution. We have analytically the form of the Airy's function near x equals 0, but it's very difficult to use these series solutions when x is much different than 0. So instead, we go to a numerical solution, but the numerical solution is aided by knowing what the right initial conditions are to pick up either this first solution or the initial conditions to pick up this second solution. We can also say something qualitatively about the behavior of this equation by considering what is the sign in front of the y term. A plus sign would be oscillatory solutions here valid for negative x, and a minus sign would be exponential-like solutions here valid for positive x. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.